What we're going to look at next is how to improve your aim. Now this is incredibly important, especially if you want your skills, your techniques, whatever you want to call it, to become weaponized, as in functional, okay, especially in sparring. So if you ever actually have to use it, the closest thing you'll get to, you know, being able to use them in a real situation is sparring. So if you want to be able to hit what you want to hit in sparring, you have to improve your aim. And there's a few phases of this. Just like we do in firearms training, one of the first phases is you'll be static and the target will be static, so not moving. Second phase would be you're moving and the target's not, or the target might be moving and you're not. It depends on what level you are and what type of training you're actually training for, basically. But then, so you've got one object moving, or one phase of movement, and then both phases of movement. So first one is I'm not moving, target's not moving, and I'll just go through basic vertical, horizontal, diagonal. And there the target is moving a little bit, but not to the point of like that, you know. So you could go through each one, you could break it down even further if you want to. You can go vertical, wait till it stops again where you're comfortable, horizontal, take your time obviously, and then where it comes back to basically not moving anymore, diagonal, okay. So, and again, however you feel comfortable. Then it brings you to the next phase of, like I said before, that thing's going to be moving and you're not. So give it, once you hit it first, it's going to be moving, horizontal, diagonal. Alright, so I can do the other ones now. I could go make it a little bit harder, vertical, horizontal, diagonal, like that. If you ever get to a point of hitting that target 100% of the time, you've gotten to a point of perfection. And what you want to be doing in this type of training is striving for self-perfection. So what you need to do is sort of tweak an impacting factor, if that makes sense. So more movement, or more movement on your part, or switching on your part like this, you know, things where you can make it harder for yourself, because if it's not challenging, you're not training. It's as simple as that. So I might increase the speed. I might point wah, 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 like that, you know, three. I didn't mean to hit it then, but I can do all three angles, you know, all three strikes, and then from there start to move in and out. So I might go vertical, horizontal, diagonal, like that. So I've got a little bit of movement with my body, my feet, you know, my footwork, and the range is slightly changing. So I could again after that start switching, just like we do in the basic templates, or again I got vertical, horizontal, diagonal. And again, I think, yeah, I hit it every time, but part of it was on the rope or whatever, so I need to start improving that and saying, okay, I want it right on the rubber bit of, you know, that. So simple as that. But yeah, so you need to work it in phases. So again, just to review, you're not moving, target's not moving. You could do each one, vertical, horizontal, diagonal. I'm just touching it if you want, that's fine. You're building muscle memory anyway through those lines. Then from there, each time, you can start off with it moving just randomly. You don't want to go too back and forth or too side to side. You want it real random. So I just hit it sort of randomly, so now it's in a circle sort of thing. Okay, so again, you go off to the left side from there. Work it really easy first. Then you come back and start switching if you want. You go vertical, horizontal, diagonal. Same on the left side, vertical, horizontal, diagonal. That was just getting it, but anyway. Again, I can start to move, even going back to the first template with my right side, so vertical, horizontal, diagonal. Include some footwork, so I'm getting more dynamic. Maybe I get a shot on the way out, you know, things like that. And again, both phases, we're both moving. But as I said, if you're getting it 100% of the time, you need to tweak it so that you don't get it every time. So that you know, you could do it on your knees, you could do it off switching every time, or you could move it in and out, and you could just do it faster in between, you know, your repetitions faster. If you can start to progressively train like this and find where your deficiency is, then you can start to fill those gaps in your progression, as in terms of, okay, I know I want to be here, but I'm actually just here right now, so how do I fill that gap? Slow is smooth, smooth is fast. So when you start to see a deficiency, you work on that area, but you always break it back down to a slightly slower, then increase speed through repetition, basically. Okay, so the more I do it, the more I build that muscle memory, the better I'm going to get at it.